Hey guys, welcome back to Coach Hall Writes. In today's video, we're going to be talking about how to improve your AP Lang synthesis and argument essays by learning how to develop a concession and refutation. So to do this, we need to understand what a concession and refutation actually are, and we need to understand that they come as a pair. A concession is the first part. That is when you concede or acknowledge the merit or the value of the opposing side. The refutation is the second part, and that is when you refute the concession and assert your position. If you've ever had a conversation with somebody who isn't willing to consider other people's viewpoints, you know how frustrating that can be. Well, sometimes it's equally as frustrating to read an essay where the writer doesn't consider the other side. And that's why a concession and refutation is very beneficial to student writers. It allows you to show a more mature outlook because you've considered the opposition, and also it can help you strengthen your line of reasoning and develop your argument even more. So then the question becomes, where do I put a concession and refutation in my essay? Some students like to do this as part of their thesis statement. I've done a couple videos on this, so I will link one here. But I want to talk about how you actually develop an entire paragraph or maybe even two paragraphs to set up a concession and refutation. So you might be wondering, wait a minute, where do I put an entire concession and refutation paragraph? Honestly, a lot of students use the concession and refutation paragraph as either their first or their last body paragraph in their essay. However, that's not to say that it can't go other places as well. For instance, it could be a middle body paragraph, or it can serve as a very well-developed introductory paragraph. One thing that's important to remember as we're working on developing our concession and refutation is that they work together as a pair to further our argument. So before you work on figuring out your concession and refutation, you need to be very clear as to what your argument is. You need to know what your thesis is and what your main points are. That way, then you can concede and offer your refutation. Okay, so what we're going to do now is I'm going to do a little bit of brainstorming for you guys. I'm going to demo how you can actually do this and think through this a little bit so you can see what this might look like in an actual essay. For this example, we're going to be answering the question, what is the value of public libraries? So what I recommend students do is to assert a position first and craft a bit of a tentative thesis. So here I've written a statement, but it's a little bit vague. Once you have your ideas on paper, then you can go back in and jot down more notes to make your wording more specific. So here it says free services. We need to figure out what kind. And also it says integral to society, but we need to figure out how so. So once you have that basic sentence for a thesis, a basic position, then you can go back in and ask yourself these questions. So what and why? What kind of services? So we have those listed here in blue. And then why is it integral to society? So we have that listed here in green. So this is going to be my position. This is what I am trying to claim in my essay. Now the next step is to figure out the opposition. So what would other people say if they don't think that libraries are very valuable to society? So they might say that libraries are outdated. And as far as why they might think they're outdated, it's probably because of the abundance of e-readers and the internet. A lot of people have access to books and newspapers anyway, so they might not need to go to the library. So that's going to be the opposing argument. So I'm going to list that here. You'll notice that I wrote the words some and most in all caps, and that's because I wanted to signal to myself that I was going to use that as part of my refutation. Basically, my idea here is that not everyone has internet access and not everyone can afford the luxury of audiobooks or online newspaper subscriptions. Now that I figured out my position, my concession, and my refutation, I need to figure out how I'm going to organize my essay. Keep in mind that on the AP Lang exam, you only have 40 minutes, so a lot of students only have time to write two body paragraphs, and that's okay as long as they are well developed. So I would start with my concession and refutation, and my commentary would be about democracy. I would use this as a bridge to go into body paragraph two, because this idea of democracy would start body paragraph two, because I could talk about how libraries are also a polling place for local and national elections, and then I could talk about the other services that libraries provide and why they're valuable. So now let's look at what a concession would actually look like. I've written one here. You can see that I highlighted the word true because that is acknowledging the merit of the opposing side. I also toyed with the phrase perceived primary purpose to check out books because that's acknowledging that there's more to it than just checking out books. And then I've given some examples in green. Now here, the word however is highlighted because that is acknowledging a shift. So this is my refutation. And you can see that I have some examples here. Also, I did use the phrase 24/7, but I put it in quotes because it is a bit of a casual expression. So that is acceptable as long as you put it in quotes, or you could come up with something more sophisticated to say. And so you'll see that this is a concession and refutation that would ordinarily go together. And here's how I would continue the paragraph. So you'll see that I started to talk about democracy, and this is going to be the commentary that I've got. So I highlighted some key phrases in blue. If you guys want to pause the screen or go back and slow this down so you could read it more closely, that's totally fine. Now, if you looked at those previous slides and you're like, Coach Hall, there is no way I could write that much. That is crazy. Ask yourself what and why. That's how you can continue to write your evidence and commentary. Keep in mind that we want evidence and commentary in layers. We don't just want a big long list of examples, and we don't want to just develop one example with some commentary. We want to show a relationship between examples. And so a concession and refutation allows you to do that. It allows you to further your argument. And so if you feel like you get stuck on these essays, try these strategies. Let me know in the comments below if you found this video helpful. And please don't forget to like and subscribe, because I would hate for you to miss out on my upcoming videos in my Cram for the Exam series. So until next time, guys, happy writing.